Welcome all to today's session of CNEWS interview, presented by the students of 2MA MCS. I am Aman Kaithath, and today I have with me Mr. Michael Tell, an aspiring chef who runs his food stall in our very own gourmet and is now all set to talk to us about his life experiences, new ventures and fitness. Hello, Michael.
Hi, Aman.
So let's begin with our questions right away.
Sure.
Michael, how did your passion for cooking begin?
I always had a passion for cooking, Aman. Right from my childhood, it started like with, you know, me going to the kitchen, sneaking into the kitchen and like, you know, stealing some milk powder, sugar and stuff like that. And then it was a transition. Then it started like me getting interested to like, you know, make teas and coffees for my uncles and aunties, you know, whoever comes home, and like, you know, me getting interested to like clean up the house and things like that. So it slowly developed like that. And until after my second PU, I was introduced to this culinary as a course, you know. I was introduced to it as a profession as well. So that's how my passion for cooking began.
So, Michael, what do you like to cook the most?
I really like cooking my mother cuisine, which is Naga cuisine. Because, you know, for a reason, I like it because it's very healthy. It includes a lot of wild herbs and like locally produced organic vegetables and very good source of protein and everything. It's there in the cuisine, and since I'm more into fitness, I like cooking my Naga cuisine the most.
This sounds delicious. So, Michael, how do you find time between your passion and your work life in terms of fitness?
Honestly, Aman, it's very tough to balance things sometimes, but right now, the transition has moved from me wanting to be fit to me, like, you know, making it a need in my life. And I have, in the process, I have understood about fitness in a very holistic manner. And I don't take it just as a bodybuilding, but I take it, I take fitness as something like which helps me to be more productive and more, active in life. So I do make time to, I dedicate like at least 2 hours of my time into fitness after work and everything. Once I'm done with like my things here in college, I do like make time to go visit the gym and like, you know, go sweat and like work hard there.
That's amazing. So Michael, how was it to work with Fresh Menu?
Fresh Menu as such was an entire different experience for me because it was something that I really wanted to do in the future, like, you know, have my own shows and have my own, like, at least, like, small YouTube videos. So I felt Fresh Menu was, like, a platform for me to, like, you know, experience that and to begin. And it was really cool to collaborate with Under 25 and do the videos together because it really helped me also boost my own confidence and, my own skills.
Michael, tell us about your new project, Ovenly.
Yes, it's an upcoming project, and it has gone into action. So Ovenly is nothing but it's a bakery, and the brand is Ovenly. And through this, we are targeting to bring in upscale bakery goods into the market and cross to a wide section of the market, especially the middle class, and we want to bring the gourmet based dishes, which are actually expensive if you go to a very high end bakery, but we want to bring those things and bring it towards the middle class and like, you know, people who like, we basically want to reach a wide variety, a wide number of clients. So that's the concept of Ovenly. And whatever like things come to my store here in Michael's Corner, it comes from Ovenly, all the baked goods. So we have initiated the process, and we will be coming up with a bakery called Ovenly.
Michael, how important do you think it is for a man to know how to cook?
Oh, I personally believe it's very important. the whole notion of only the ladies, only the girls or only the women has to cook, has to be in the kitchen. I think those kind of concept has been already erased from the, like, you know, mindset of this generation, especially with the number of youngsters, especially like guys getting into, men's getting into into the field of cooking and culinary. It is also important because it is a life skill at the end of the day, you know, like you survive with it, you know. No one takes it from you, you know. If you learn how to cook, that's good for you because you want to make something special. You want to make someone like feel good. You want to make something special for your loved ones. Like you get your hand into it, you know, without ordering food from outside. So it is very important in many levels. And it's a very necessary skill, I guess, like even the guys have to cultivate.
What message you would like to give to all the aspiring chefs of our very own university?
Well, first thing is you need to hustle hard and be humble enough to learn. Yeah, you know, open up yourself to learning, whether it is from anyone like who is reputed or it is just from like, you know, some person who is like just cleaning up the kitchen. It's very important to always keep your, like, you know, mind open to learning. And yeah, be humble, work hard and pray hard so that the rest will fall in place.
Well said. Cool. Thank you for making time for us, Michael.
You're welcome.
That will be all for this week's C interview. Have a pleasant day, everyone.